Hello, Dr. Khan, Khan Center for Cardiac Longevity. Well, it seems every time I talk to the public about plant-based, plant-strong, completely vegan diets, one of the questions come up is supplements. And there's some easy and simple rules that have changed a little bit lately. Pretty much everybody would agree if you're completely plant-based, you're eating zero animal products, which is the best choice for your health, for the planet, and for the animals, that you take B12. Now, this would not be probably the one you take. This is a B complex I use in certain patients with certain genetic defects. But we're talking about 3 times a week, 250 micrograms. I like sublingual B12. That way it doesn't have to go to the stomach to have activity. It's absorbed right through the lining of the mouth. Some people that are completely resistant may need intramuscular injection, quite uncommon. I don't think I have any patients doing that. That's number one. Number two, everybody has recently sort of rallied around the idea, not everybody, but most, that some plant-based vitamin D3, and some vitamin D3 comes from the secretions of lamb. It's called lanolin. But there are many brands of vegan vitamin D3, if that is important to you, and I think it's a consideration and should be. 2,000 international units a day is a good amount that won't get you into trouble. Now, if you take 20,000 international units of vitamin D3 a day, you might get into trouble. It's a fat-soluble vitamin that's stored in the body, and over a few months, that might make you very sick. 2,000 international units a day. It might already be in your multivitamin, might be in your fortified plant-based milks. Lately, this has been added to the group. Dr. Furman makes a algae-based EPA DHA omega-3. This is a brand called Deva, D-E-V-A, that makes a number of vegan vitamins. They make a B12, they make a nice choice for vitamin D, but this is their new, it used to be just DHA, now it's EPA DHA, which are the omega-3 fatty acids active in cell membranes. There are others that could be considered, but those are the big three. I personally am a big fan of vitamin K2M7. This is a nice vegetarian source from natto, N-A-T-T-O, which is a type of soy, very common in the Japanese diet, very high blood levels in the Japanese diet because they're eating natto sushi, fermented sushi. It's a soy that's made into sushi. Quite uncommon in the United States. Interesting data that the higher your blood level is of vitamin K2, the more resistant your arteries are to getting calcified, aged, and deteriorated. And I'm all about young arteries. So you eat for young arteries, you might need to supplement for young arteries. So that's the news for today, the top three with one bonus information. Be sure you do it. I always say be a smart vegan. Take advantage of the benefits. But if there's a couple of weak spots, fill them easily. Bye-bye.